Today I'm going to start installing some seat belts into the mule. I already know this project is going to be a giant pain in my ass because I have to install the seat belt retractor and I don't have no room for no seat belt retractor. See, I thought it would be a good idea to start restoring this car stereo system first. So I built a giant ass subwoofer box. It's in the way. To install these seat belts, I'll have to cut a hole to flush mount the retractor. The shoulder strap bracket needs to be bolted up at the top, and then the lower strap needs to be bolted down again at the bottom, so you pull the belt across, click it into the other belt strap that needs to be bolted in. This is gonna require 75 bolts. Amplified is produced by Soundman Enterprises, Inc., Mobile Solutions, and CT Sounds. I'm gonna start with the driver's side because that's gonna be the hard side. So first I need to slide the subwoofer box out and finesse a hole into the side of the panel. Are we gonna work or goof around?
I'm down.
Goof around?
Yeah.
Oh. Okay, sit on the other seat so I can get this out. We gotta extract this from its hole. From its home. Easy on the brake lines.
Oh, Dada.
Gonna gently pull this out of here. We're just gonna slide this out. Oh no, there's a scratch on the top. I'm gonna have to repaint it. Oh, my foot cramps. My foot cramped.
Daddy, no foot.
What? Well, move your foot then.
I don't know, Dada.
My plan is to mount the retractor as low as I can because that's where I have the most room. So I need to cut a hole so I could drop the retractor down in to the body, and I'm hoping I could use one hole to sandwich the OEM sheet metal between the retractor and the lower strap bracket. The new bolt for the upper strap bracket fits right into the OEM hole, so the top is good. That'll save us a lot of time. And look who the cat dragged in. Spoon!
Twiddle.
Now you get some motion in an episode.
He said he was going to help me with the mule 5 years ago. He came back.
The hole's not that big.
No, but it's not going to work.
Yeah, why?
Do you have another size nut, sir?
Oh, yeah, you know what? I don't know if I'd be able to pull this nut, sir, yet. I need to be able to thread this.
I bought this Astro nut insert tool a long time ago. I want to use it right now, but I fucked myself. I have some 3/8 insert nuts, but I don't have the tool that goes onto the Astro tool to pull the 3/8 insert nut closed. So now what?
So this is, I don't know if you have the tip.
The mushroom tip.
Is it the wrong tip?
Yeah, but you replace the tip.
Oh, that's way too small.
This is what's gonna suck right here.
It vibrates the thing when you roll it.
Yeah, but.
So have you seen those crazy holders?
This ain't a roller coaster, dude. This ain't a fucking roller coaster episode, Spoon. We're not trying to show what it looks like to be on a goddamn roller coaster. Let me see that.
This insert nut tool works like a rivet gun by crimping the nut onto your piece of sheet metal.
1/4-20. Fuck.
I need the right end for this tool that threads onto this insert nut so it can crimp the insert nut onto the sheet metal. It does me no good unless I have the right piece. A little fucking piece. Now I have to weld a nut to the seat belts. I'm gonna burn the straps. It's gonna weaken the nylon. If I get in an accident, the nylon's weakened. I'm gonna bust my fat belly out of the seat belt strap, fly through the window, the car's gonna run me over. My oil pan's gonna hit me in the back of the head. It's gonna say fuck off on the back of my head.
Fuck off!
Now I can't insert my nuts. Until later, until I go to Rob's mom's house.
Seriously, don't fuck around right now, fuck off!
Bastardize these holes out on the seatbelt bracket just to fit the insert nut, and I can't close the insert nut because my tool is missing a piece. This is frustrating. Frustrated. I'm always missing something. I got all this shit, but I'm missing something. I'm just going to weld a nut on the back of this bracket because I'm not going to be able to get to the back side of the retractor once I drop this into the hole. So I need to weld the nuts on so I can drop my nuts in the hole. So I'm just going to weld the nuts on, drop my nuts in the hole, have Rafa's mom drop me back off of the shop, drop the retractor down in the hole, tighten it with the lower bracket. See what I did there?
Oh, fuck yourself.
This is a tight fit inside this hole. This retractor barely fits. Everything's bolted into place. This bracket is bent, has an angle to it where that lower strap is. I'm really hoping that clears the subwoofer box. I was able to shift the box over just enough to to where it doesn't even touch the lower strap, everything's good. The seatbelt smoothly retracts, the top pivots nicely. Now I just need to do the other side and then mount the buckle side of the straps. The buckle side of the seat belts will just bolt straight to the floor, so that should be pretty easy. I ordered the 3/8 tip for my Astro nut insert tool, so hopefully we'll get that soon, and we could also put some insert nuts for the seat bolts finally, because the back seat bolts on both sides suck because there's nuts to get underneath there and they don't line up right and they fucking suck. I gotta crawl my ass under and then I need to get to both ends, which means my face is in the right in the fucking edge of the fucking, I got door sill in my mouth. So we use insert nuts for the rear seat bolts and for the buckle side of the seatbelt straps. Thank you guys so much for watching today's video. Make sure you come back next week for 5 fresh new episodes of Amplified. Leave a comment, hit that thumbs up. We'll see you next time. Support Amplified by going to soundmanca.com and picking up an iPad dash kit and Soundman merch. Go to mobilesolutions-usa.com and book your car audio training and check out their tools. And go to ct-sounds.com for some innovative car audio equipment from a company that's giving back to the community.